I just built a brick wall and slammed you right against it. And I hope that you stick.
Right now, where are we going, Farmer?
We are on the way to Houston for the FOD meet.
Alright, since he said that, I gotta get my seat in the proper driving position for Houston. Anyways, so yeah, we're going to Houston. We're gonna go link with Kev and have a meet. So, look, I want y'all to see this really quick. Zoom in on that right there. Alright, earlier was at 101 degrees. It's freaking crazy.
Alright. We've just arrived at the Topgolf. Whoa! They got a little bit of torque to it. They have golf, but do they have top? That's the question.
Hey Kev.
Hi.
Nice to meet you finally.
What's up? Oh, we gotta go play some top golf. I never played top golf before.
I haven't been here in years.
Really?
I don't remember shit.
All I know is man, we thought it was the Tahoe Cannon, bro.
It was the Hellcat.
It's not even a Hellcat, bro. It's a Camaro.
What you think about that, Kev?
It's alright.
It's alright. It ain't
bolt. I'm telling you, bro, this is the color.
Come on, man.
It's like Gap.
What gap?
Look, let me show you something.
Show me something.
A lot of y'all don't know Super Light. SL. Supposed to be on a race car.
But it ain't.
That's why they come with no center caps. You can't put a center cap on them. But guess what?
He did that.
Stance car. Made it a little bit faster.
Probably a lot faster.
A lot faster.
About what? Like 800 wheel or so?
Either, bro,
no,
we'll see you guys right inside. Now. All right, guys, we are officially made it to Top Golf.
How do you feel, AJ?
Hit it, baby. Let's go. I'm already a member. I'm already ready.
How do you feel, Kev?
Good. It's all in the hips. It's all in the hips.
AJ said he's a professional, so I'm backing up.
Ball him.
Yeah, my back. It's the rotator cuff. It's all fucked up.
He claims that he's hit the back fence before.
I have.
All right. Kev's up next.
Go ahead, Kev. Oh, right in the yellow. Oh, you made it.
Be outside, baby. Be outside.
Guys, speed run, top ball.
I think that's it. You throw that last one, see if he gets some four. Who are we going to meet?
Ahmed.
Ahmed?
Famous. He's very famous, Ahmed.
Kev, do you know this guy?
I do.
Oh, okay.
What's going on, AJ? Nice to meet you, man.
The Farmer. Best angle is the one from the back.
Farmer.
AJ, how's it going, man?
Yeah. I was just letting him borrow my car. But let me show you the...
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Show me what you got done to it.
This right here, custom. Custom. I just had that done at the body shop.
Actually, they just did that for me. So.
The world's strongest man.
I'm going to pull it out for him really quick now.
Wait, how old are you so I can clickbait the title?
How old am I?
Yeah.
15. I was like, it's fine. You can go.
All right. I am riding in a 15-year-old's... BRZ right now, the lowest in the world actually. How low are you right now? Yeah, maxed out. What are we, like a half inch off the ground? I gotta make it bounce more.
Ah, That's 32k. They're actually stiff as shit, but.
It's so fucking hot. Let's compare foreheads.
I got an African forehead.
Walking lick, just like grandma, I can't walk without a stick. Fuck a bitch, cut her off and off, boyfriend on my dick. 30 clip, if he pull it out, he gon' get hit. I'm the shit, when it come to brown boys, I'm good as it get. Talking shit, burn a car and throw him in a ditch. Popping shit.
Alright guys, sadly, this is all the cars that pulled up to the Fear Dime meet. There's some over there. Stinky Kev. Trunk hit. How do you guys feel about the meet so far? It's great.
Just started, baby.
No, it just ended.
What's up, Kev? What's up, man?
What's up? It's okay. You can be in the video. Say what's up.
People spend $200 to $300 on shoes. I'm like, $300 is good enough for me.
Exactly. That's why you gotta rock these bad boys.
100K car.
Yeah, exactly.
Exactly.
I'd rather ride with holes in
my
underwear than socks.
And drive that.
That's inspiration. That's inspiration right there.
Yeah, that's choice.
That's choice.
That's choice.
I'm dead serious.
I can go home and show you a pair of underwear with holes
in it. Tonka, Tonka, Tonka. Who is this? Who is this?
Bro. Guy? About OG. To find out who it is, man.
Get your fine ass out about that truck, boy.
He's short, bro.
Yeah, he's so short. Holy shit, bro. You're tall,
you
gotta
bro. Get a hug, man.
Thanks, what's up? On, dude, holy shit, you're tall. I did not know you were that tall.
Guys, so y'all know.
You're 6'8".
I'm 6 foot tall. Actually, yeah. Straight, I'm 6 foot tall.
6'6"?
Just about.
Yeah, right close enough.
So,
it might just be water. Where's it coming from?
Oh, that's not water.
I think it's orange juice or something. You think it's orange juice?
Nope, right here.
Oh, that's Coke, yeah. But what do you think's leaking? What do you think?
It's not water.
It's not water? Nah. Well, as y'all can see, things are starting to get a little crazy. Everybody's starting to show up. Got BRZs, Scion FRSs, S2Ks, E92M3s, Chargers. VAs, LS400, Hondas, the fucking Dune rig. All right, for it. LC500, yeah, there we go. That's static, I didn't even know that. Okay, so this is the question for you, okay? All right. So you've been following since probably what, like 10, 15,000 followers, somewhere in there?
Yeah.
What made you follow Fear Dying?
Not just like, the way you wanna like reach out to like people, make things accessible, not just like, not in it for the greed, not in it for the money. Like, you're in it for, like, because you want to make people, like, feel like your family, make friends, make these, like, relationships. You're like, oh, like, buy my merch, you know? The only way you can support me is if you buy my stuff. Like, I respect that you don't do that. You want to, like, genuinely get to know people and, like, really be about the relationships that you want to build. In the end, like, money's not going to be there for you, you know? And the way you just, like, you make it accessible to everyone to buy, like, to support you, that's what makes it feel like a genuine connection.
Yeah.
That's why I really love like, Fear Dying.
Well, guys, we're eating ramen with the guys. Jeremy, Kyle, Kev, and
Dave.
Dave. My bad, I forgot his name. I just
wanted to.
Woo-hoo-hoo! It's deep in these streets. Where are we at, bro?
We're at Muse Hookah Cafe.
What's it called?
Muse Hookah Cafe.
Muse, oh wait, no, that's the wrong sign. Muse, it's over there. Muse Hookah Cafe. First time here. Ahmed drug us along.
Day two, guys. You see where we're at? We're out here with Kev. He's gonna show us all these, the Supras that he's just letting his buddies borrow. This is actually his buddy's Porsche that he's just letting, well, it's actually his Porsche, he's just letting his buddy borrow it right now.
Yeah.
Well, let me show you guys, this is the new Fear Dying store right here. Can't get in right now, I forgot the keys, but yeah, that's that. We woke up kind of late, so yeah. I think a lot of people are gonna be leaving.
It's okay. Show us the way, Kev. Dude, that pain goes crazy. Pain goes bonkers. Is he okay? Yeah.
It's different, for sure.
Definitely drifty. It's cool. It's like my E46, but just executed a lot better. You like this color, Vet?
Yeah, that's a good color. Yeah.
This thing is sick, dude.
Yeah.
Kind of attack Supra. I like his plate.
Supra.
The log, look at his plate cover. The fucking M plate. He's got a good sense of humor about it.
Ooh, E46.
All right, where are we at?
We are at the world famous Rice Box. The aesthetic in here is top notch.
It's unmatched.
I would eat here every day. Well, that's if the food was good, but it's probably gonna be good.
Yeah.
Hey, look at AJ. He's so happy. Look at him.
What do you think, Kev? You've been here many times?
I have.
What do you think about it?
It's a pretty good place to be. Good place to hang out with your friends.
They do some photo shoots here along the wall at nighttime. That's what I've heard.
Yeah, we should have. It'd have been cool to. Oh, should have been here last night.
That'd yeah.
I hope he's as tall as he looks in his photos. Oh, shit.
You guys can have sex now.
Oh, my God. Yo, yes, dude, sir. That was really intense. Do it one more time.
Hell no.
Hell no.
This shit crazy.
21!
Woo! Happy birthday. Yo.
We about to go into the Buc-ee's right now and check out some of the merch, so we'll see you inside.
Fun.
We just got done in the Buc-ee's and
we played with those tubes. That was fun.
Yeah, we got to go get a classic pick with the Buc-ee's Buck Beaver.
He's a good looking fella.
Hey, yo.
All right, tell me real quick, y'all. So how'd y'all meet?
I had him on Facebook for like a good year or so, and then I was looking for a palace shirt.
Yeah, it was a palace tee, right?
I DM'd him, and it was a fucking... It was two palace shirts I was looking for. It was the trim, and the one with like all the vegetables and shit on it. He didn't have neither, and then we just started shitposting.
No, I had him. I just didn't have the color and the size you needed. That's what it was. I had him in the big boy size.
Like I said, he didn't have what I needed.
And that's it. That's the story of how they met.
Yeah,
and y'all been friends for how long?
About six or 5 years now, just been nonstop shit posting on each other's walls.
And now y'all finally met in person.
Hell yeah, dude.
How's it feel to finally meet in person?
It's strange. It's yeah. Strange, man, yeah.
It's crazy.
Just like calling this motherfucker and just go like,
calling me, he be calling me all the time and I'm like, dude, I am so busy, I don't want to pick up.
It'd be like that.
No, he be calling when the vinyl machines are cutting. I'm like, I can't hear nothing, bro. Yeah. Wee, wee, wee.
You ain't finna be late.
I'm gonna be late as
hell. Hey, appreciate you.
Appreciate you.
God. You're so strong.
Hey, this is my new crib, y'all. Two bedroom, all right? Check it out.
No, Kizzy, bro.
Everything iced out.
And that motherfucker got AC?
Yes, sir. Hey, y'all gotta get up out of here. I'm going, I got things to do. I'll see y'all.
We're on the e-scooters right now. You already know.
Yeah. Woo! Oh, my God.
Whoa. Gosh dang.
Yes, sir.
Tell me this is not the most fun you've almost had in your entire life.
I almost had fun, but I'm not.
YouTube, it's me, Farmer to Rudy 69.
I'm not drunk enough for that, bro.
When I get drunk, I got an early intro.
Really aggressive one.
Oh, God.
He's gonna ask me.
Yo guys, we are on our way to the burger joint. We just got done riding scooters, and now we're gonna go get some food.
Go on, bust it open, go on ahead, baby, get naked. Know you got a nigga, but I wanna see you get naked. Deep throat, baby, go on ahead, take a nigga on the strip. All the bitch while he in Vegas, say you getting money, but the whole world know you fake out.
We're deep. We're at, let me see this. The burger joint, we made it. Everybody made it, all one piece.
Kev and I don't know. It was a close one.
Not it, nah, I'm just kidding.
It was fine.
All right, well, we just ate at the burger joint.
Maybe there's cops talking to a girl.
Yeah, for once. I'm so proud. AJ, explain what's going on.
We got to meet up with the famous Q60 on Swangles and Elbows, bro.
Let's go.
This shit crazy. Oh my fucking lord. Googly, googly.
All right, so tell us about your painting, if you could.
All right, so what we have right here is pretty much Autoflex Express mixed with House of Colors Candy. It's Autoflex base coat. It's a black flat base coat. And it's orange over silver.
Okay.
House of Colors Tangerine Orange. And we got some clear and a bunch of flakes and all kind of crazy shit going on with the paint right now.
Check that.
So how long you have the car for?
I got it at the end of 2020. So far I started customizing it like around Christmas time. The first thing I did was I ended up bagging it. I have a custom setup, pretty much Acura V3. A manifold with 3/8 lines, and I'm running an ABS switch remote, and that was like the first thing I pretty much did. And after that, I started putting the wheels and
go ahead and tell the people how much these Swangas cost.
Well, these particularly are H&S G18s. They roughly go between $7,000 to $9,000. I got mine for $85. I actually have the fifth as well. It's not put on because I don't have the bumper for it. That's another story. But yeah, they're a pretty penny. They're not the same price as three-piece wheels. Shout out to people who do ride three-piece wheels, but people who, I can't really say people who voice their opinions on these wheels, because they probably don't even fucking have a car. But for the main part, it's a whole different caliber when it comes to these wheels.
So what wheels did you say they were again?
These are Texan wire wheels. This size itself is 18-inch G18s.
Yeah, because I know a lot of people who fuck with us and fuck with, you know, the stance cars and stuff like that. They probably don't really fuck with something like this, but
yeah.
I think that's the big thing.
And normally, the Vogues.
A lot of people that normally don't fuck with them don't have no opportunity to obtain them. So if somebody can't get something, of course they're going to have something to say about it. Because people who really understand the culture and understand what the process is with this car, they can respect it. And then at the same time, it really don't matter what people's opinions is, because people say shit all of the time when it comes to the internet, but when they see me in person, they tell their tale. So.
Spending all my time up there getting faded. Yeah, handing out the E to the entertainment. Yeah, you know on this side it's popping and it's dangerous. Pop it. Riding through the clouds, we going through the vapors. I'm just trying to get the.
Tell us a little bit about the culture though. Like, what really got you into this, and then what do you really know about the background of this? Okay. We're not from Houston, you know, so we just visited out here.
So I came up around the slab culture a lot growing up. You know what I'm saying? My parents, my uncles, a lot of my people basically was riding slab. So for me, I kind of came up around the slab scene, but I have love for Japanese culture as well. So for me, I was the one who basically put it together to come up with a JDM sports luxury vehicle and to basically put elbows on it. People was like, why? Well, it's because you have to have taste and you got to have some creativity. I could have got a Cadillac or a Lincoln or whatever the case may be and stick to the same platform, but I did that already. So I was trying to switch it up a little bit. And to be honest with you, I really wasn't even looking into getting a Red Sport. I was initially looking for a GSL, but I couldn't get the GSL, so I ended up getting the Q60 Red Sport, and it was just up from there.
I think that this was a great chassis and a great platform to merge the two, and it is a Red Sport, so that's even cooler. Yeah.
Let me give you this disclaimer right now. Just because y'all see this car with these wheels on don't mean that you're eligible to do this shit. First of all, like, they're dangerous, they're not safe. Somebody will literally take you out your car for these wheels. They're not to be played with. And then, in addition, that don't mean that you finna go get a 370Z and think you finna strap this hoe down. It's not happening like that. You gotta have the right vehicle. You gotta have the right vehicle, the right motherfucking, like, you gotta make sure everything is correct. don't just go buy no wheels. You got to make sure your suspension is right. You got to make sure, like, everything when it comes to the chassis of the vehicle, the suspension, everything to that magnitude is good before you even try to do something like this. If you're able to do something like this, because there's not nothing you can go into a tire shop and be like, hey, I want these wheels.
Yeah.
Like, you got to have the right people to be able to get shit like this.
Right.
Just
so there's
let y'all know.
A lot of culture behind it.
It's a lot of culture behind it.
I love it.
Like I said,
it's so cool. This is literally like the first time that I've ever seen a car with elbows. Like,
right.
I think it's so tough.
Yeah, no, that's crazy in person.
Like, well, it's not done yet, but I think you executed like so well. I saw your phone as white.
It's still a work in progress, you know what I'm saying? I know it's not done. A lot of people are going to.
So, yeah, y'all don't really know, but this thing is crazy, crazy in person. Like that paint, the flake. Yeah, y'all really don't know. It's crazy in person. You even got people out here. We in Houston right now just checking it out.
Like around Saturdays and Sundays, if you stay in Houston, you probably know. Carrington's the spot to be when it comes to slabs.
Where is it at? What spot?
Carrington, or AKA Carroll. You got that. You got McGregor Park. You got MLK.
Yeah. You going out though, man. Hey, you going to bring the scene worldwide for real with this one. The scene definitely going worldwide with this one. The culture, and that's the big thing, you know. That's what we just trying to show people, the culture, and just get out here. And
I'm just ultimately putting on for the city, bro. That's all it is. And I'm breaking that barrier. Like, I'm the one that's been the trademark of Stan Slab, straight up. Like, that's just what it is, because that's exactly what it is. Like, I didn't just get a car and put wheels on it. I literally built the suspension. I'm literally, you know what I'm saying, still finna get under the hood.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just a bunch of stuff I'm going when it comes to this car. I'm not even done. I had the car for almost 2 years.
And
it's gonna be complete by the end of the year. So
what's,
I'm even sure this too.
What's like something that you really see for this chassis that you don't have for the car that you really feel like you really want for it? Nothing?
I have
everything. I feel it.
I'm good.
Little touches on it too, like, it's just all the chrome and stuff.
So it used to be a really big thing as far as those particular rims, as far as people getting jacked, getting killed, and all kind of shit. But now it's a different thing because they reproduce them. It is truly a Southern thing.
Yeah.
Truly a Southern thing.
Hey, thanks for putting this together, bro.
Yeah, I appreciate you.
Hey, you already know. When you see Psych on IG,
he'll hook you up with anything and everything.
Yeah.
Where we at? Tell him where we at.
Are we on the south side?
Where at? What city?
Houston, Texas.
Come on, you already know.
Spread it out, spread it out, spread it out. Mosh pit.